dominates you.
How do you see God in your everyday life?
I'm atheist.
I'm making
you. I'm believing God.
I'm not religious at all.
It's not anything really physical, it's more of a cerebral kind of concept to me.
Okay. Probably
like a big, tall, out of the beard, wings maybe.
The old-fashioned way. That's what I heard, that being up in the sky, looking down.
I feel like you slack a little bit. I think I
just have it. I immediately think it's just a picture of Jesus, I guess. I mean, I'm a Christian, so maybe I should have like a physical picture of God, but no, I don't think of it that way. I feel like Christianity would make sense if you thought of like a picture or something.
I don't think there is an image of God. I don't think that's what I'm saying. Like, non-existent. I don't think there is an image of God. The vision of God will appear to be different to everyone who seeks to find Him, and ultimately does find Him. So, it changes.
The question that was raised is, how do I see God in everyday life? I pretty much see it every day as I work at this art museum. We focus on the importance of art and the Bible. And what we do here at the museum is we exhibit art in a series of different exhibitions that last for about 3 to 4 months at a given time. The art has been created within the Judeo-Christian tradition, dating as far back as antiquity to contemporary times. For me, having the opportunity to go to school at Fordham, as well as having the opportunity to go to other Catholic schools and to bring the knowledge I've attained from my schooling to working at a museum that focuses on religious art, it is a very beautiful communion between the two. And I'm allowed to truly live my life and see God in all the things that I do. It's a very beautiful connection between my personal life and my religious life and my spiritual life, my academic life, and my professional life.
Mark Chapman, and I'm the pastor of the Hollis Presbyterian Church in Hollis, Queens. I've been the pastor here for the last 3.5 years. Well, I see God in my everyday life in many ways, from the time I wake up in the morning to the ways in which the Lord gives me strength to do the work that I'm called to do. Sometimes I get very tired, I grow weary, sometimes I get depressed. The living God is that power, that eternal power that comes to strengthen me in my time of need. So I see God at work in my life every single day. Just the joy of my relationships. I see God most clearly in my relationships. There's something very powerful about the way in which God has connected us. And He has so arranged it that we are interdependent. So the Spirit of God, I think, is at work in our daily lives, most clearly in our relationships as we relate to one another. And in our church family, the men, the women, the boys and girls that make up our congregation, the connections that bind us together, I think is a very clear sign of God's presence in our daily lives. The living God, that phrase means to me that we serve a personal God.
Oh, no, someone died.
Yeah.
It was this 100-year-old violinist who used to play with the Metropolitan Opera. His name was Henry Castro. After he died, I felt like he was moving my Boeing arm. That's the first time I ever had that feeling that someone who had died was kind of with me.
A God that is actively involved in our lives.
I see evidence of Him in even getting up in the morning. I've been in situations where I had to question my very sanity, and the fact that I'm still able to remember, or to, some people call it, habitually brush my teeth, get dressed, do all of those things we take for granted. He gives you the ability to do those things. And then there's things that I'm, you know, as far as food, provision, shelter, loved, to love someone, all of those things is very evident that He's in my life every day. I know this sounds kind of cliche, but it's very, very true, you know.
It's people's pain, it's their suffering, it's their moments of crises, it's their situations of despair, their discomfort, moments of affliction that leads people to search for God.